Before you to read the communique which I'm about to read, but before I do that, allow me to congratulate the just sworn in Deputy Executive Secretary of Corporate Affairs, Ambassador Joseph Andrew Norris, and to welcome him to SADC and to the SADC Secretariat, a very lovely family. Before I proceed, we also heard from the chairperson, while concluding his remarks, that it is time to deliver, and we commit to deliver, Your Excellencies. The communique for the 38th Summit, SADC Summit of Federal State and Government, Safari Court Conference Center in Namibia, 17th to 18th August 2018. Number one, the 38th Ordinary Summit of the Heads of State and Government of the Southern African Development Community was held at Safari Court Conference Center in Windhoek, the Republic of Namibia, on the 17th to the 18th August 2018. The summit was attended by the following heads of state and government. Number one, Angola, His Excellency President João Manuel Lourenço. Number two, Botswana, His Excellency Mokgweetsi Masisi. Number three, DRC, His Excellency President Joseph Kabila Kabange. Number four, Mozambique, His Excellency President Filipe Jacinto Nyusi. Number five, Namibia, His Excellency President Dr. Hage Geingob. Number six, Seychelles, His Excellency President Daniel Freire. Number seven, South Africa, His Excellency President Cyril Ramaphosa. Number eight, Zambia, His Excellency President Edgar Chagwa Lungu. Number nine, Zimbabwe, His Excellency President Emmerson Mnangagwa. Number 10, Lesotho, Right Honorable Prime Minister Dr. Thomas Thabane. Number 11, the United Republic of Tanzania, Vice President Samia Suluhu Hassan. Number 12, Eswatini, Honorable Senator Paul Dlamini, Deputy Prime Minister. Number 13, Comoros, Honorable Manuel El Emis Seif, Minister of Foreign Affairs, International Cooperation, and the Francophonie. Number 14, Madagascar, Honorable Dovo Maxine, Minister of Foreign Affairs. Number 15, Malawi, Honorable Dr. Emmanuel Fabiano, Minister of Foreign Affairs and International Relations. And number 16, Mauritius, Honorable Umar Suintel, Minister of Agroforestry and Food Security. Your Excellencies, the order is in line with the alphabetical but also priority where a member has been represented by a minister. Number three in the communique, summit was attended by His Excellency Paul Kagame, the President of Rwanda and the current chairperson of the African Union. The summit was also attended by Her Excellency Dr. Stephomena Rowan-Sachs, the SADC Executive Secretary, His Excellency Mustafa, the chairperson of the African Union Commission, and Her Excellency Dr. Vera Songwe, Executive Secretary of the United Nations Economic Commission for Africa and Africa. Number five in the communique, the summit elected His Excellency Dr. Hage Geingob, President of the Republic of Namibia, as the chairperson of SADC, and His Excellency Dr. John Pombe Magufuli, President of the United Republic of Tanzania, as an incoming chairperson of SADC. Summit also elected His Excellency Edgar Chagwa Lungu, the President of Zambia, as the chairperson of OGAN, as the chairperson of OGAN on Politics, Defense and Security Cooperation, and His Excellency Emmerson Dambuzo Mnangagwa, President of the Republic of Zimbabwe, as the incoming chairperson of the OGAN on Politics, Defense and Cooperation. Number seven, summit commended the outgoing chairperson of SADC, His Excellency Cyril Ramaphosa, the President of the Republic of South Africa, for his exemplary leadership during his tenure. Number eight, Summit endorsed the 38th SADC Summit theme, which reads, promoting infrastructure development and youth empowerment for sustainable development. As the 2018-2019 theme, which takes forward the SADC industrialization agenda while focusing on infrastructure development, youth empowerment, and sustainable development. Number nine, Summit approved the operationalization of the SADC Universe of Transformation in the form of a virtual university to focus on entrepreneurship, innovation, commercialization, technology transfer, enterprise development, digital, and knowledge economy to support SADC industrialization agenda. Number 10, Summit noted the progress in the implementation of the revised regional indicative strategic development plan 2015-2020 and the urged member state to focus on implementing priority activities within the approved frameworks of the revised regional indicative strategic development plan and their policy documents, including the industrialization strategy and roadmap, regional infrastructure development master plan, the regional agriculture investment plan, and the strategic indicative plan for the organ on politics, peace, and security. Number 11, Summit noted progress made in the implementation of SADC industrialization strategy and roadmap 2015-2063, and asked member states to remain committed to the implementation of the SADC industrialization agenda as the overarching priority of the region. Number 12, Summit received the SADC regional economic performance report and asked member states to scale up efforts aimed at diversifying the economies, improving domestic revenue collection mechanisms, and manage public expenditures. Number 13, Summit noted the overall decline in food production in the region for 2017-2018 crop season and urged member states to put in place measures to tackle food insecurity in the region while developing contingency plans to enhance crop preparedness in view of the likelihood of adverse El Niño-induced conditions during the 2018-2019 cropping season. Number 14, Summit noted that the Union of Comoros has deposited her instrument of accession and commended the Union of Comoros for acceding to the SADC Treaty and becoming a full member of SADC. Number 15, SADC reaffirmed SADC position that the current African, Caribbean, and Pacific negotiations and decision-making governance structure be maintained. Number 16, Summit urged member states that have not signed or ratified the Tripartite Free Trade Area Agreement to do so, and they urged member states to expeditiously finalize the exchange of tariff offers and pave the way for the implementation of the Tripartite Free Trade Area. Number 17, Summit endorsed the 23rd of March as the day of commemorating the Southern African Liberation Day. Number 18, Summit noted that the SADC Solidarity Conference with the Western Sahara will be held in October or November 2018 and it will be hosted by the Republic of South Africa. Number 19, Summit noted progress in addressing SADC proposals on the ongoing institutional reforms of the African Union and a reiterated disposition toward the reforms commitment towards the reform and a call for continued consultations with a view to addressing the outstanding issues, and the summit mandated the chairperson of SADC to fast track these consultations. 20, Summit thanks His Excellency Paul Kagame, President of the Republic of Rwanda and chairperson of the African Union, for accepting SADC's invitation and for attending the 38th Summit of SADC heads of state and government and for his continued commitment and leadership toward the implementation of the African Union institutional reforms. 21, summit noted with concern that despite a number of ASADC initiatives in the Kingdom of Lesotho, progress on the implementation of the reforms, roadmap, and national dialogue remains very slow. 22, summit asked the Kingdom of Lesotho and all stakeholders to ensure that the National Leaders Forum, scheduled to take place on the 23rd and 24th of August, takes place as planned and called upon all stakeholders, including those who reside outside, to participate. Summit resolved not to entertain any further delays in the implementation of the reforms of the National Dialogue and called upon SADC member states to take necessary measures against those with intentions to delay or threaten to derail the reforms and the national dialogue processes. Summit asked the Kingdom of Lesotho to put in place a program with clear milestones for the implementation of priority activities and reforms roadmap and national dialogue, while recognizing that SAPIL and the SADC preventive mission in Lesotho, that is SAPMIL, and the Oversight Committee tenures end in November 2018, and a report of which to be submitted to the chairperson of the organ by 30th October 2018. 25, summit thanks His Excellency Cyril Ramaphosa, the President of the Republic of South Africa, and the facilitator to the Kingdom of Lesotho, supported by the facilitation team, for his continued facilitation in the Kingdom of Lesotho. Summit commended His Excellency President Joseph Kabila, Kabange Kabila, and the government of the Democratic Republic of Congo for upholding the Constitution of the Democratic Republic of Congo, and they noted that the government of the DRC will continue to provide the necessary funding and logistical requirements to enable the conduct of a peaceful and credible elections. 27, summit commended the government of Madagascar and the political stakeholders for reaching an agreement that facilitated the appointment of a new prime minister, His Excellency Christian Tsai, and the formation of a consensus government, and they urged all political stakeholders to ensure that the upcoming elections take place in a peaceful environment. 28, summit congratulated member states that held elections since the last summit in August 2017, namely the Republic of Angola and the Republic of Zimbabwe, and congratulated His Excellency President Joe Manuel Lorenzo and the Movement for the Popular Liberation of Angola MPLA Party for winning the elections, and called upon all stakeholders in Zimbabwe to remain calm while the legal processes regarding the outcome of the elections are being considered by the courts, and to respect the will of the people of Zimbabwe. 29, summit asked the international community to lift all sanctions against Zimbabwe and support the Republic of Zimbabwe in her economic and social development efforts. 30, summit commended His Excellency Juan Manuel Lorenzo, the President of the Republic of Angola and the outgoing Chairperson of the Organ on Politics, Defense and Security, for his outstanding leadership in steering issues of the organ during his tenure. 31, summit approved the declaration on eliminating malaria in the SADC region to firmly press regional malaria elimination on the agenda of all SADC member states. 32, summit noted that the tenure of Ms. Emily Nshobekwa, the current SADC Deputy Executive Secretary of Corporate Affairs, is ending in October 2018, and thanks her for the services rendered to the Secretariat and the sent to the region. Number 33, summit approved the appointment of Ambassador Joseph Andre Norris from Seychelles for the position of SADC Deputy Executive Secretary of Corporate Affairs. 34, the ordinary summit was officially closed by the SADC chairperson, His Excellency President Dr. Hal Gengo, who thanked all the heads of state and government for attending the 38th ordinary summit of SADC heads of state and government. 35 and last, summit expressed its appreciation to the government and people of the Republic of Namibia for successfully hosting attendance at the 8th Ordinary Summit and for the hospitality during the summit period. Done in Windhoek, Republic of Namibia on the 18th August 2018. That is the communique which has been adopted by this summit. As I